What's up everybody, Abstract again, doing a how-to video on how to get your sound-activated cathodes, like these, working outside of your PC. So how to get them connected to the sound module and powering up without having to connect them to your power supply inside your computer. Now this process is really similar to connecting them inside your PC, but there's one specific part you'll have to buy in order to get this to work, but we'll go over that in a minute. Now first what you're going to do is you're going to go to xoxide.com. That's on the screen, and you're going to find their lighting section. And in there, you'll find cathodes like these. These are 2 12-inch. You can get them in a pair. I think it's a pair for like $7.99, so it's pretty cheap. I get all my lighting mods there. They also have the sound module. That's pretty cheap as well, and any extension cables like these. They come in 12 inches. I had to get one just because in order to put one on the bottom of my monitor and one on the top, I needed a little longer length to work with. You only get about a foot to work with on the stock, so if you think you're going to be spacing them out any farther than that, you're going to want to get an extension cable. And they also have tons of other mods that you can check out. I mean, they have 15-inch cathodes, 4-inch, 8-inch, all different lengths, different kinds. So you can look around. I'm pretty sure all those will work with this. So now, what the important part is how to power them up. So this is what you're going to need to get. This is an AC-DC to Molex adapter. I couldn't unplug it because I had issues connecting it. But pretty much it plugs into the wall. There's a little power brick, and then it connects right to your sound module via Molex. So what you're going to do is you're going to go to newegg.com, and you're going to type in this item ID number. You have to get this exact one, because a lot of these do not have the required ground connector in the Molex that you need in order for the cathodes to work. There are a lot of AC-DC to Molex adapters, but they don't have the ground connection in the Molex. So if you buy one of those, your cathodes aren't even going to power up at all. So you have to get this exact one. This is one of the few left that actually works. So make sure you get this. This is the OK Gear adapter. So when you get your cathodes in the mail, they'll come in a box that looks like this. Inside you'll have your two cathodes, or however many you ordered. And you'll also have Velcro, sticky on one side, Velcro on the other, so you can stick them to whatever you want, like the back of your monitor or a wall. And you'll also get a couple other things. You'll see this in the box. Since you got the sound activated module, you won't need this at all, so you can throw it aside, you'll never need it. And you'll also have a switch like this that you will never need either, so you can throw that aside as well. And then you'll get your sound activated module right here. Also couldn't get that disconnected. So keep that in mind. Once you connect it, it's pretty much done. So you'll have that, and then that also comes with this, which is your adjuster. So if you were connecting it inside your computer, obviously this would be going in an empty expansion slot. I just set it on my desk. But pretty much middle is off. I don't know which one it is. I think up is always on, so your cathodes will always be on. And if you switch it down, then that activates your sound activation. So once it's sound activated, you can use this knob. And the farther you turn it clockwise, the more sensitive it gets. The farther counterclockwise, the less sensitive it gets. So you'll have to mess around with that quite a bit until you get it set exactly where you want it to go off with your music. It can be a pain in the butt sometimes, but it's not too bad once you get used to it. So that's everything you'll get. Then pretty much you just have to connect it. So your two cathodes, if you have an extension cable, you'll plug that right into the sound module. On one end there are two 2-pin connectors. That's where your cathodes go. It can support up to two. And then on the other side, there's a bigger 4-pin. That's where this will go. And there's another 2-pin, which is where your Molex power will go, and then that'll connect in to your adapter that you got that plugs into an outlet. Alright, then once you have all that connected, you'll probably have a mess of cables like me. Your power brick should have a green light on to show that it's powered up. Then you'll have your sound activated module, which I just set on the side of my desk. And then that's connected to your cathodes. So I've got one back here on the bottom of my monitor, and one up on the top. Now, if it's not powering up, you're gonna wanna be careful with this Molex connector. At first, when I tried connecting it, these cables right here actually popped out of the Molex connector. So just make sure they're pushed in all the way. It doesn't matter if they pop out, you can just push them right back in. But mine wasn't powering up at first, and then I noticed these were popped out. So make sure those are pushed in all the way. And then you've got your controller right here. I actually had it backwards before. Bottom, you push it down, then they're always on. Middle is off. And then to the right, the sound activated, and this will light up blue. And then you can see whenever you make a noise, your cathodes go off. So if you guys have any questions, post a comment, like, share with your friends, subscribe. More videos coming soon. I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.